Hello and welcome to the session. In this session we will discuss about logarithm. The logarithm of any number to a given base is the exponent to which the base should be raised to get the given number. So, like if we have log of the number n to the base a is equal to x. This means a to the power of x is equal to n. For example, if we have log 100 to the base of 10 is equal to 2, this would mean that 10, which is the base, to the power of 2 is equal to 100. Then logarithm of 1 to any base, so base a, is equal to 0. Then logarithm of any number, say a, to the same base, say a, would be 1. Now if the base of the logarithm is not indicated, then the base is taken as 10. The logarithms calculated to the base 10 are called common logarithms. And the logarithms with base e are called natural logarithms. Now we discuss the components of logarithms. We have two components of logarithms, which are the characteristic of the logarithm and the mantissa of the logarithm. Now the integral part of a logarithm is the characteristic of the logarithm, and the decimal part of the logarithm is called the mantissa of the logarithm. First we discuss the characteristic of a logarithm, which is the integral part of the logarithm. The characteristic of a common logarithm, that is a logarithm which is calculated to the base 10, this shows the position of the decimal point in the associated number. So this means if the characteristic is known, then the position of the decimal is also known. Now let's discuss the rules for determining the characteristic of a logarithm. For this, if we have that the number whose characteristic is to be determined is greater than 1, then in this case the characteristic of the number would be positive and it would be equal to the number of digits to the left of the decimal point minus 1. Let's now find out the characteristic of logarithm of the number given as 27.003. Now, as this number is greater than 1, so its characteristic would be equal to the number of digits to the left of the decimal point, which would be 2 minus 1, that is 1. So its characteristic is given as 1. And if we have the number to be less than 1, then in this case the characteristic would be negative and the characteristic would be equal to minus of the number of zeros between the decimal point and the first non-zero digit of the number plus 1. So if we have to find the characteristic of logarithm of the number 0.003, as this number is less than 1, so its characteristic would also be negative and this would be equal to minus of the number of zeros between the decimal point and the first non-zero digit of the number. So as you can see, there are two zeros between them. So 2 plus 1, which is minus 3. So characteristic of logarithm of 0.003 is equal to minus 3. Next is the mantissa of a logarithm, which is the decimal or the fractional part of the logarithm. Now the mantissa of a logarithm remains same for the particular sequence of digits regardless of the position of the decimal point. Now if we have log 11 is equal to 1.0414, as we given the log of this number, so we can easily find out the characteristic and min tisa of this logarithm. As we know that characteristic of a logarithm is the integral part, so it would be 1, and min tisa is the decimal part, so it would be 0.0414. So this completes the session. Hope you have understood the concept of logarithms and the components of logarithms.